Hey guys, my name is Zero X Shinobi, but you can call me Zero. I decided to make a list of 7 games that I enjoyed quite a bit this year. It won't be in any particular order, so don't expect this to act as a Game of the Year video. If you don't see any games on this list such as Dragon Age Inquisition or even Bayonetta 2, just know that it's because I barely got to scratch the surface of those awesome games. These are games that I did get to devote my entire attention to. Maybe in the future I'll make a backlog Game of the Year list to give others the shine that they deserve. Let me know in the comments what games you enjoyed this year. So alright, let's begin, shall we? Ubisoft may have had a bad year in the eyes of many gamers, but to me, I only played one of their games this year. Watch Dogs was set to be the GTA 5 competitor in 2013, but they chickened out and delayed it about, 6 months? Well, I don't want to imagine how the game would have turned out before the delay, but what I did play was fun. I mean, the graphics weren't the best, the world was somewhat barren in comparison to Grand Theft Auto 5, and some would even say the game was too long for its own good. I agree mostly with all those statements, but again, it doesn't take away from the gameplay. The story missions aren't the best part in my opinion. I had the most fun playing the side missions like criminal convoys and clearing gang hideouts. The absolute best part about side missions is there's an incentive to completing them. For instance, you want to breeze through story missions? Get the silenced Uzi, known as the Spec Op SMG-11, by completing all gang hideouts. Want a super-powered sniper rifle that disables any vehicle with one shot? Get the Destroyer by completing criminal convoy missions. Do you want a one-shot kill handgun like the Desert Eagle? Stop crime throughout the city. All these missions are not only fun, but also the weapons that you get or obtain increases the game's fun factor greatly. I can talk about this game for a long time because of my experience playing it. I say if you haven't tried it out, at least rent it. There's no in-game timer, but I'm pretty sure I clocked in over 50 hours in this game. Come on, do I really have to explain why I enjoy this game so much? Is Smash Bros. Taken to high definition with even more playable characters than before? There's a few fighters that decided to skip out on this entry, probably because their muscles are still sore from Brawl, so I don't blame them. But the new additions are freaking awesome. I hate Pit now, but I do love the hell out of Pac-Man and Sonic. Sorry Pit, I'll pick you up later on. Sadly, the classic mode is a bust, and there's no real single player campaign like in Brawl. That doesn't keep the game from having a ton of stuff to do. Events are especially fun, challenges are really addicting to complete as well. They may be a tad pointless, but come on, it's achievements / trophies before they were standard in video games. The amount of stages in this game make me smile. I hate playing fighters with only 6 stages. I'm looking at you, Street Fighter Cross Tekken. Look, you can't go wrong with this game if you loved any of the previous entries. I do wish the game had Star Wolf. That way a certain someone I know could get his ass raped by my Sonic. You know who you are. Come on, bruh. Let's do it. Gamescom 2014 held one of the best announcements, in my opinion, of the year. Serving as a demo to the upcoming Silent Hills game, PT was released onto the PlayStation Store as the first playable teaser for a console game. PT is the scariest shit I have played in my entire life. The demo has you controlling a mysterious character and walking through an endless loop of hallways in what seems to be a nightmare of some kind. As you continuously find yourself walking through door after door of the same rooms, you experience a ghost coming out of nowhere at the sound of a bell tower, meet an ugly bitch who probably has never heard of a shower, you run a marathon coked up, and you even try picking up ringing telephones after hearing babies laugh. It may not be as random as Slenderman turning you around or popping out of nowhere, but this demo contains the creepiest atmosphere to ever haunt a video game. You can thank the sick minds of Hideo Kojima and Guillermo del Toro for the twisted nightmare that is PT. Do yourself a huge favor. Download the demo, turn off the lights, raise the volume, and play by yourself. And then you tell me if you played the demo to the very end and weren't scared not one bit. I think this was the year of horror games, and I'm surprised on consoles we had a good amount of releases as well. Outlast may not be as sick as PT, but the game does have a ton of jump scares. You are put in the shoes of a reporter equipped with only a camera who seeks out to uncover the story at an asylum that not many have the balls to even do the research on. In the asylum, you see a lot of deranged patients along with dead SWAT members. As you progress through the asylum, you then discover footage of what seems to be a ghost. Yes, a ghost, killing the SWAT members. At this point, there's no turning back as you are then found by a chained creature that looks like he hits the gym hard. At this point, this is when you learn to hide, run, or sneak to get past the enemies that will haunt your playthrough of this game. Mind you, there's no weapons in this game at all. No form of self-defense. The only defense you have is running away. The scariest moment I had in this game had to be when I found myself in a pool of sewage water being chased by the steroid-induced Hulk-looking prisoner. Check out this game if you love horror games, because it is a trip, and it is awesome, and it's pretty long too, and somewhat challenging as well. Strider was a game I had no faith in. Once I read that the game was going to be Metroidvania-esque, I was afraid. It's almost as if every little downloadable title these days has to be in that style. I also didn't believe in the developer behind the game, Double Helix, which honestly didn't have a great history of games at the time of announcement. I couldn't have been any more happy with what I played. Strider was one of those games that just kept calling out to me when I wasn't sitting playing it. Running from room to room, cutting cyborgs down, along with the awesome boss battles, captured the old school Strider, although it did feel more like Strider 2. I played the game on the PS4, so the gameplay was silky smooth with no noticeable hiccups, which was amazing. Music was a little with the exception of a couple of themes, but trust me, the sound effects make up for that. I say if you haven't tried out this game, definitely check it out, because it's one of Capcom's good games as of late. I'm going to be honest with you, I wasn't into the Evil Within playing its first couple of hours. I felt as if it started out like a budget title. I hated how the main character moved. The story was odd to me. The graphics weren't great for a PlayStation 4 game. It was PS2-ish all around, but a lot of people said it was awesome, so I kept playing. Everyone who recommended it compared it to Resident Evil 4, probably because the great mind of Shinji Mikami was behind it. Some even went as far as saying that it was his next Resident Evil 4. Now, I wouldn't agree with anyone who says that, but I did find the game to be a lot better than I initially thought it to be. Once I completed Chapter 5, I realized that the game just had a rough start for me. The game is so tense later on that some of the boss battles had my heart racing. Spoilers, without much spoilers, the parking lot fight with the giant spider slash human centipede asshole was insane. I did start off the game on survival mode, so maybe that has something to do with it, but ammo management in this game is essential. Sometimes, it's just not even worth fighting enemies, and that's what I love so much about the game, its difficulty. Even the story picks up later, and the art direction is pretty great too. So I say, if you didn't like the game in the beginning, check it out because it does get better, and it ends up being one of the best games, in my opinion, of 2014. When I first saw Rogue Legacy and read about the gimmick it had on the Metroidvania genre, I immediately put it off. This is a 2D side-scroller that not only gives you control over a knight, but rather his entire lineage. The goal is to enter a castle that at the very center lies a powerful enemy that needs to be taken down. When entering, you are presented with a randomized map layout. Each layout is brutal, filled with creatures such as zombies, flying skulls, undead knights, and the bosses. Oh man, the bosses. They will kill you in seconds if you don't either have the experience or reflexes to dodge everything they throw at you. Rogue Legacy makes it clear, in order to defeat the challenges within the castle, you must, I repeat, you must embrace death. With death comes a new protagonist to use, and although you lose him or her forever, your next offspring will take on all of their stats, abilities, equipment, and level. Death is never truly game over, but rather a checkpoint. It acts as a time to look at your weaknesses and strengthen them up. That way, when your next kin steps up to the castle doors, he or she can be better prepared for the threats inside. The game is a hack and slash fest. I downloaded it the day it was released on PS4, and mainly because I was bored. But I clocked in about 18 hours, and it ended up being one of the best purchases of the year, hands down. I beat it twice, and you can even continue playing the game over and over with an unlimited challenge as it gets tougher with each completion. I can't recommend this game anymore, and one piece of advice. If you want to take down bosses, use the ninja. Period. No questions asked. There you have it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please share, like, and comment. Tell me what the games you enjoyed this year were. And if you guys want to see more of these kinds of videos, let me know in the comments. I really need to know. I need your feedback, guys. It really helps me. And again, be sure to look out for my top 20 PlayStation 1 games from my childhood, with memories included, which is coming later at the end of this year. Again, thank you guys. Take care.